Hey, how's it going? Drainus here. Welcome back to Diablo 2 Resurrected. In this video, we will cover the sorceress a bit more. So yeah, let's join me. So, the sorceress in Diablo 2 Resurrected is a mage-like character. And when you start, you have the choice between three different skill trees. So you have the fire spell skill tree, the lightning spell skill tree, and the cold spell skill tree. The fire spell skill tree offers Firebolt, Fireball, Meteor, and Fire Mastery. We also have Warmth, Enchant, and Hydra. And then we have Inferno, Blaze, and Fireball. To make sure these ones unlock on level 1, these on level 6, these on level 12, these on level 18, these on level 24, and these on level 30. Firebolt is just a bolt of fire. Then you have Fireball, it's a bigger bolt of fire, deals more damage. The Meteor skill, also very nice to use, just a big ball from the sky and lands on enemies. But remember, this one has a casting delay, as you can see, so it's sometimes a bit hard to cast on the right enemies. And then Fire Mastery. Every skill tree has a mastery skill, and these will do some special things. So for example, in the fire skill tree, all my spells will do plus 30% more damage when I learn this. You can also see the arrows. The arrows point out that you need the skill before leveling the next one. So for example, if you want to learn Enchant, we have to get Fireball because of the arrow, and we have to get Warmth. But yeah, fire can be very strong, especially in the beginning. So these are just damage skills. Also Firewall, Blaze is very funny. There will be a fire trail when you walk. And Inferno can also be very funny, but not very good. Then we have Warmth. It's a passive, and it increases the rate at which you recover mana. Then we have Enchant. Enchant can be very fun. You can enchant allies and yourself, and what this does is it gives them fire damage and more attack rating. And then we have Hydra. Nice skill, multi-headed beast of flame, and it deals damage. So this one is especially good in the beginning, but later in the game you don't really need it. As you can see, I only have base 1 in this, and because of my plus skills from all my items and such, I get 9. In the beginning you can invest a bit in this, but late game I would not recommend investing much in Warmth. But yeah, fire is very good, very strong, nice effects, nice animations, so definitely check fire out if you like it. Then we have the lightning spells. We have Charged Bolt, Lightning, Chain Lightning, Thunderstorm, Nova, Static Field. And we also have Telekinesis, Teleport and Energy Shield. And last but not least, we have Lightning Mastery. So, I really haven't played Lightning that much. It is because, as you can see, Lightning damage always deals 1 to a certain number of damage. And I really don't like this random effect, but it can be very strong, and also it looks very good. So for example, the chain lightning will just hit between enemies. So yeah, very fun. But the lightning skill tree has some skills that are very good and almost a must have. For example, static field, weaken enemies by 25%, and this also works on bosses. So you reduce the life of bosses by 25% each time you use it. And we have teleport here. And this one is a very must-have skill also. But to get teleport you need telekinesis. So definitely pick up teleport once you can. 1 point is enough. And then we have the cold skills. I'm a cold sorceress myself. We have frozen armor, shiver armor and chilling armor. Then we have ice bolt, ice blast, glacial spike, blizzard, frozen orb. We also have Frost Nova here, and we have Cold Mastery. Now, as you can see, the Cold Mastery here is a bit different than the other masteries in the other trees. And this is because the Cold Mastery reduces enemy cold resistance. And this is especially good on higher difficulty, because most of the mobs will have a lot of cold resistance there. And what this does is you deal a lot more damage to them. So yeah, definitely pick this one up if you're cold. Then I have the frozen armor. I only have one point in this, but I mainly have this for the extra defense and the freezing for 2.5 seconds. And then my main damage skill is the frozen orb. It is very good and very strong, but as you can see, the frozen orb receives bonuses from Icebolt and it only gets 2% damage per level. So for example, if you take the fire skills and we look at the fireball, you can see it gets from 2 skills plus 14% fire damage per level. So the cold skills don't really benefit from each other, but the frozen orb is very strong. It will freeze enemies and it's a big area of effect skill. So yeah, definitely check this one out if you want to be cold. So what should you pick when you take the sorceress? I would recommend picking up fire at the start, because you will get fireball very soon on level 12 and you deal a lot of damage. And to get the frozen orb you need to be level 30, so this will take a while. But I would also recommend maybe picking up one point in frozen armor and picking up static field and teleport. All the skill trees are very fun to play. It's really balanced and really nice done, so definitely check them all out. If you like, if you think I would like to go lightning, go for lightning. If you think I would like to go for cold, go for cold. It's up to you. Then my character stats. The sorceress is a bit weak. It has a low defense, but it compensates by this by having teleport, for example, and freezes and things like that. Also, as you can see, I've saved points again here. This is because whenever I'm getting a new weapon or armor, I can invest these points and can wear the weapon or armor instantly. My items, let's go over them real quick. I have this one, that's Phantom, plus 3 to sorcerer skill levels, plus 20% faster cast rate, always a nice stat to have with sorceress, because your teleport will be faster, your skills will be cast faster, and this one also gives plus 28% to cold skills damage. So yeah, very good one to have. It's a bit hard to find. Then my helm. I have a rune ward in this one. Delirium. I have this mainly because of the 2 to all skills and the 25% better chance of getting magic items. The 1% chance to cast level 50 Delirium when struck isn't really that good for mage, because when I'm in this form I can't cast any skills. So I'm thinking about changing this one up, but I'm not sure yet. Then I have Skulder's Ire. Plus 1 to all skills, and I have this mainly because of the 101% chance of getting magic items. My amulet, plus 3 to cold skills, very good rule, haven't found a better one yet. Then my shield, I also have a rune ward in this one. Spirit, plus 2 to all skills, faster cast rate again, and some resistances. My boots, just blue ones, but this is only because of the 28% better chance of getting magic items. Then I have a Nagelringring. This one is a bad roll, but it is still better than nothing, so this is why I got it. I have the Gold Wrap, mainly because of the 30% better chance of getting magic items. And then I have this ring, very bad. I only have this one because of the generate mana now, but I really like to have another Nagelring here. And my gloves, I have this only because of the 25% better chance of getting magic items. I have also a small charm with 7% better chance of magic items, and a grand charm with 9% better chance of getting magic items. So yeah, as you can see, this is a magic find build. I really like it in Diablo 2, you can just farm bosses and do things like that, and just farm items for your other characters. The last thing I would like to mention is my mercenary, and I mainly have this one because of the weapon, the Insight. I've talked about this a little bit before in my other videos, but this one is very good, especially with mage and other spell-oriented characters, because it gives the meditation aura, and this generates mana for me, so you can keep up all your spells non-stop and just make sure you are teleporting around. And the nice thing about teleport is, once you teleport, your mercenary will be on your spot where you're teleported to, so He won't die very quickly, since he's always near you when you teleport. But yeah, Sorceress is very fun in Diablo 2 Resurrected. Definitely check it out. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like. And I see you in the next one. Bye.